Welcome back. Looking into the components of classification, there are two basic components, that is a category and taxon. Category or the taxonomic category specifically, it is a definitive rank in the hierarchical system of biological classification. So what is the actual rank over here? So the lowest rank actually it is a species, right? And the highest rank it is a kingdom. So, what are the different seven? There are actually seven basic taxonomic categories which are obligatory. Okay, so seven obligatory taxonomic categories are considered to be the basic categories, and they are kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. Species being the lowest category or the most fundamental among the category, and while the kingdom is considered to be the highest one in the hierarchy. Okay, so these are the categories. Now, what is taxon? Taxon, it is a named taxonomic group of any rank. So, we can say it is actually named category. So, specifically, if we say kingdom Animalia, that is a taxon. But if we say just kingdom, it is a category. Okay, similarly, we have phylum Chordata, that is a taxon. But phylum, it is a category. Kingdom Plantae, that is another taxon. While kingdom, it is common category. Okay, I hope it is clear. Okay, so when we speak about taxonomic category, it is a definitive rank or level in the hierarchical system of biological classification. Okay, and there are seven basic or primary categories which are considered to be obligatory taxonomic categories, and they are from the highest to the lowest, if we rank, it is the kingdom, then phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. Okay. In species, as we already mentioned, it is the lowest category, while the kingdom is the highest one. Each category above the level of species contains groups of lower categories, which in turn contain still more groups of still lower groups. That is, you can see one example is like family, Canidae, we have different genus, genera. Okay, while a genus may include several species. Okay, I hope it is clear. For example, we can have like Panthera. Panthera, it is a genus. And what are the species coming under that? Panthera leo, Panthera tigris. Okay, Panthera leopardus. Panthera leo is actually a lion. Panthera tigris is the tiger. Panthera leopardus is the leopard. Okay, so you can see there is a single genus, that is a Panthera. It includes several smaller species. Okay, several species. It is included in the same genus. So we can say that above the level of species level, each category contains groups of lower categories. Example, Panthera is a genus. Okay, it is above the species level, and it contains several groups of lower categories, and here what it refers to, that is a different species. Okay, so Panthera is a genus which includes Leo, Panthera tigris, Panthera leopardus. So these three are the lower categories coming under the category of genus Panthera. I hope it is clear. Okay, so family is a category containing either a single genus or more genera. Okay, so single genus, if it is, we call it as it could be a single genus or more than one genera. Okay, so similarly, genus, it is a category containing either a single species or more than one species. Okay, and if a single genus contains more than one species, we call such a group as monophyletic group. Monophyletic group. I'm sorry, I haven't given it over here. It is monophyletic. You can just, I'll just try to write it. Okay, with a pen. It is monophyletic. Okay, it is single. That is mono. Okay. So this is monophyletic. Okay. If it is monophyletic genus, that means the same single genus may contain more than one species. Okay. If it is a monophyletic family, that is the family may contain more than one genera. Okay, so that is how it is monophyletic group. I hope it is clear. Okay, so the rank of a category is either its absolute position in the hierarchical classification or its position relative to other categories. Okay, that is with respect to, you can see the, 1 minute. Okay, with respect to species, the higher category is the, next higher category is the genus. Okay, so I hope this one is clear with respect to the category. Now, what is taxon? Taxon, as we already mentioned, it is a named taxonomic group of any rank in the hierarchical classification. So, we can say, as per Simpson puts it, it is actually a group of real organisms recognized as a formal unit at any level of hierarchical classification. So, the rank of a taxon is that of the category of which it is a member. So, the members of a taxon show higher degree of similarity. For example, if it is, we are speaking about the species Canis lupus, obviously the members of Canis lupus will show more amount of similarities, okay, more amount of similarities among themselves, a higher degree of similarity with respect to any of the characters we are mentioning, for example, morphology, anatomy, phyletic or what you call genetic. So, it will show more amount of or more degree of similarity among themselves. Okay. Now, taxon, it is the name of a group of similar or related organisms, while category, it is a rank of the taxon in the hierarchy classification. Okay. Few examples we can see. So, here the category is the genus. Okay. Taxon, it is a genus Panthera. Okay. And this genus Panthera, it includes more than one species, like Panthera leo, Panthera pardus, and Panthera tigris. Okay. So, I hope it is clear. Another category, it is a family. Okay. And the taxon is specifically this family Felidae over here. Okay. It includes Panthera, the three species of Panthera, then different species of Felis. Okay. So, Felis domesticus is our common cat. Felis caracal and Felis concolor, this puma. So, all these comes under the same family. I hope it is clear. Okay, when we speak about the category genus, in with this particular figure, in the category genus means it could be genus Felis and genus Panthera. These two are different genera or different taxon. Clear? I hope it is clear. Okay, so that is with regard to the classification. Moving on to the next basic concept which you are already familiar with, it is a nomenclature. Okay, we will be dealing with in detail the classification, different types of classification in the coming classes, but I thought we'll, in this particular level, we will just like brush up whatever you have learned in your previous classes. So, what is nomenclature? Simply, nomenclature means naming, to call an object by a name, that is nomenclature. Okay, so as Simpson puts it, it is providing a distinctive name to each of the groups recognized in any given zoological classification. Okay. So, putting a name means naming an organism, it is nomenclature. Okay. So, a scientific system of naming the taxonomic groups or taxa that are recognized in zoological classification is nomenclature. So, when we speak about Panthera as a genus, it is a nomenclature. Okay. We have given a name to the taxon. So, that is a nomenclature. Hope it is clear. Okay. So, it is a formal naming of a taxa in the scheme of classification. And why it is so important? We can see why the name is important. Okay. This particular flower you are very familiar with, isn't it? But I am listing over here a few names which are common in India. Okay. Obviously, it is not complete list. I have just put few examples from Kerala. That is, these four are the names for the same flower. Okay. At various parts of Kerala, these are the names. Okay. Obviously, when we speak, when we try to communicate with a particular name in a different part of Kerala, what happens is, they may not understand that we are speaking about this flower. They may have this, a flower of a different kind with the same name. That is a problem. Okay. So, it will be very difficult to communicate if we are using the local names or what we know call as a vernacular names. Okay. Like, this is all Malayalam names, this is English names, and here we have Hindi. And Tamil, we have two names. Okay, one is Betsy and this is Eclipse. Okay, so all these refer to the same flower. So you can imagine, I've just listed three languages. Four, it is very common. But what happens is, still we don't have a single name for this flower or plant that can help us to communicate in any part of the world. So that is how a scientific system of nomenclature comes into being. Okay, that is how it is so important. That is, scientifically, if you are working on a particular plant, it will be easy to communicate with other people working on the same plant in another part of the world. Okay, if a person is working on Ixora, that is Ixora coccinea. This is the name of the particular flower. Okay, so Ixora, if I am working on Ixora, and if I want to communicate with someone in, just imagine, like Malayan archipelago or in Philippines or somewhere like that, okay, where this particular flower is found, okay, I may not be able to use the Malayalam name because it is not a familiar name, or they may not be familiar with the name. So, for a person in the scientific world who is working on the same group of organisms, it will be easy if you use a scientific nomenclature, okay. And the best one widely accepted is a binomial nomenclature. Obviously, there are different kinds of nomenclature which we will be looking in detail in the coming presentations. But here, which you are familiar with and which is widely accepted, this is a binomial nomenclature. The term says, obviously, nomenclature refer to naming, isn't it? Binomial, that means two names. Okay, so here the each organism will be getting two names. Two names in the sense, two words in the name. Okay, and this was put forward by Linnaeus, Carolus Linnaeus. I hope you know the story that Carolus Linnaeus, the actual name was Carl von Linné. He was a Swedish scholar and who was interested in studying organisms. And in his book, Systema Naturae, in 1735, that was the first time he mentioned about the binomial names and method of classification. And interestingly, Carl von Linné, he changed his name to a binomial system. And that is how Carolus Linnaeus came into being. That is what is said in Vedic textbooks. Okay, so that is again interesting that he changed his own name as per the binomial nomenclature. So each species will be given a double name, and it is made up of, you can see, this is the genus name, and when we put this together with the genus name, it becomes the species name. Okay, so this is the genus name, or we call it as a generic name, and this is a specific name. We don't call it as a species name. Species name is actually Homo sapiens. Okay, while this one alone, it forms a specific name. Okay, this is the generic name or the genus name, and this is a specific name. Put together, it is the name of the species. And always, a binomial nomenclature will have the name of the person, we call it as an author, name of the person who studied the particular species scientifically for the first time and published the detail and made it available to the rest of the world. Okay, so Homo sapiens, the name was suggested for the first time by Linnaeus. Okay, and which year it was? It was in 1758. Okay, so this is the complete binomial nomenclature. And I hope you all remember, you have already studied that always binomial nomenclature will be having a Latinized names, that is the names from Latin. Okay, even nowadays, even Sanskrit names, Hindi names are being added, taken, but it is Latinized. For example, if a particular species is having a species of insect is having a green abdomen, okay, the name we can suggest for the specific part. Okay, it could be Harita. Harita in Sanskrit, it means green, isn't it? So we just Latinize it and call it as Harita. Okay, that means it has something green in its body. So somewhat like that. Okay, so this is always the Latinized name. Secondly, these names when printed, it should be in italics. Okay. Since it will be difficult for a person to write in italics, we just underline that. Okay. So what we do, we underline the terms when it is handwritten, but it should be separate. That is, Homo and sapiens will be underlined separately. Okay. So it should be Latinized. It should have two words in the name. First one is generic name and the second is specific name. And it should be in italics when printed. It should be underlined when it is handwritten. A few examples are. Okay, this is all national and state organisms. Panthera tigris, this is a Bengal tiger. Pavo cristatus, the Indian peacock. Platanista gangetica, it is a national aquatic animal. Elephas maximus, it is a Kerala animal.